Linkstore.com, a loja pioneira na compra e venda de skins. Vendemos skins com os melhores preços do Brasil, fazemos upgrades nas suas skins antigas e aceitamos encomendas da sua skin favorita. Temos diversas skins como facas, luvas, armas, adesivos e mais. Compramos seu inventário completo e o pagamento é à vista para qualquer banco. Utilizando meu cupom ALEARTO, você vai ganhar um desconto exclusivo para suas compras. Milhares de recomendações e 100% de qualidade garantida. Não perca tempo, link na descrição.
Momentum, get that confidence, and that's where train can fall apart. So for MIBR right now, the name of the game is starting strong. Get those rounds on the board early. Get in Luminosity's face. Show them that they should be feared when being peaked.
It'll be interesting if we, after all the creativity we saw and on-the-fly calls that we saw on Inferno, if it ends up just being a really straightforward B take for this. Good grenade is aired out. Oh my goodness, that grenade hits just about everybody for 30, 40 damage in there. Right now, MIBR is trying to extend the push, secure more and more territory. Don't get pinned into the back of that yard. So you've got Fur and Taco that are pushed up quite far.
And we do see the flank from Lucas just waiting as Henny does take down Taco close up. Lucas should be starting on this flank momentarily as Steel getting gooshed as he tries to jump up towards that upper balcony area.
He actually drops down because he thought it was an HE coming his direction from Fallen.
Yeah.
Now he's behind the tanker train
and
behind Kerr, but he chokes the shot, turned back around. Henny's able to pick that one up, and it's a 2v2. The kit's in hand, the time's going to be a problem. Great shot from Nekis. He's on the bomb.
Oh.
He's standing and ducking, and Coldzera will take both players out.
Not doing anything.
Doesn't do anything over the top. Nekis as well. He's smoked off at the bottom of the ladder, though. Bolts does pick off one at a distance as he starts to fall back. MIBR, sure, they've gotten a kill in response, but they haven't secured the site. They may stand on it, but it's still worrisome.
Steel
wraps around. Great shot on the bomb planter. Fallen will go down. Like I said, you needed to secure the site. Nobody from Luminosity was showing. And Steel with a second 1D. It's now Coldzera and Phelps. Coldzera's taking a licking from the 50 cal.
Oh, my goodness.
Steel continues to lay down the law.
What a wrap.
A 4K for Steel. Starting it off, taking down that bomb carrier as well. That just extends the round. Fur's just given actually access to the bottom of the ladder now, but they still can't get to that site. We're down to 13 seconds, and it's 3v3. Somebody has to just bolden up, get in there, and put the bomb on the ground.
Cold might be able to pick one up here. But Steel there coming around, taking.
Everybody from MIBR had bought, and I looked at Fallen's money. He hadn't bought anything yet. He still had just a pistol. He had 4,400 bucks. So he was just shy of being what he wanted useful in this round, it seems.
Henny,
two kills for Henny. And we
didn't even have
that.
To move his crosshair there. Just left it simply there, and both the MIBR players dropping into his frame.
Well, just,
he's going to pick up some kills.
It seemed like a waste of utility for me. Here comes a smoke towards Henny, but they had dropped two Molotovs and now a third Molotov just at the bottom of the ladder. That doesn't clear at the backside of the ladder. You have to have that Molotov set up that bounces through the window up there and really pushes that player out. And that round just never even gets started for MIBR. They throw Molotovs in the exact same position.
Fallen now.
Yeah, the first off to come in were halfway through the first half. Gunfire outside. Henny is probably going to be one of our standout players. He is 13-2, 14-2 right now. There's no stopping him. He's even flirting on the outside of this one, going to his sidearm, challenging Fur directly. Low HP for him, but he has bomb control. He'll throw a fresh molly in and a flank coming to the rear side.
Exactly.
Steel should have fallen, no problem. Wouldn't even doubt it if he stabbed him. No, just end his life quickly. Now Fur has nowhere to go.
Yeah, that was a great aggression from Steel to go towards Ivy very early on. MIBR going for that fast ladder, absolutely getting decimated as Henny picks up three of his own.
Good nade damage, though. Okay,
yeah.
Here's a start. Nades hitting Steel and Nekis, both for about 50. But now you've got upper box halls control for MIBR. Getting a bomb plant should be relatively easy as well, because Luminosity's default for this B site, I haven't seen anybody playing up close to that ramp. I haven't seen them playing that shoulder peak drop molly except for like way, way back at like the fourth or fifth round, something like that. So they're just going to let them have it. Let them have that. Let them walk into the site, maybe walk into just some spam fire. Man, Phelps just tapped against him. And he goes down. They've lost their second as well. They'll try and push deeper into the yard as quickly as they can. First spot, Steelers up the ladder. He hasn't spotted Fur yet, but yes, he has. He'll end him, and it's a 1-for-3 trade. Luminosity's happy about that one right now. Coldzera right now on the catwalk. He'll tap. He finds one, and he finds two. What a great shot on the second one as well. He's looking for Bolts as well to be able to tap him through, but Bolts has a scope. Colt's just trying to be as small as he possibly can. There's a couple pixels there. Bolts ran out of ammo, though. Now it's up to him to get a fresh mag in and try and come back into this round 1v2. Cold has been super annoying to him up there. He keeps absorbing damage. Dude. What a tank.
And Fallen now taking him down. Bolts up there could not.
And he just remains. And now there's no more angle after that to be able to deal with him. Lucas, fast play right up through the box halls. And Cold Zera has him dead to rights. Difficult to change your aim. Oh my goodness. Taco's burning. Oh my
and
god.
He comes out. He's going to get a second.
He's got two kills. And now it's Bolts and Henny left to defend an AWP and an M4. And suddenly MIBR look to try and close out this half with a respectable score.
Yeah, really off the back of Taco there. Cold, yeah, he gets the aggressive player towards ladder. But after that, Taco flying down past that Molotov, flying out ladder, able to pick up the first frag. And then his teammate, the Luminosity teammate, who was getting ready to trade, actually catches a flash, allowing Taco to pick up another nice second kill. And MIBR, well, they're going to get their third
Phelps,
on the board.
Phelps has bolts. Long flank. When you have five alive for the T side and you're looking to push in, end some lives, get some long flanks in, make sure that weapons are not saved, because as a matter of fact, Steel might have a boatload of cash. He has $9,000, but he has to rebuy himself. So Henny holding onto this AWP
is huge.
Is huge.
Yeah. Yeah, he's going to be able to drop a gun to either Lucas or Nekiz.
Steel Bolts. Will be able to share a gun.
Yeah, Steel will probably drop a gun. We'll get it.
Okay. Bolts back there. He's just the ladder. Now he's going to start to look the lane. Taking his first skirmish, he'll lose to Gold Zera, who's actually lights out ever since. I mean, he's 16 kills right now. He's actually the second top fragger in the server.
And so they take down Bolts, and at this point in the round, now look at how many people they have positioned on the Z. If any of the Luminosity players tried to come out, they'd be getting into such a firefight, most likely losing one or two members, Dallas, that it's not even worth it to them. So they're going to save right now. They're going to look at the following round to make this little comeback happen or maybe get their 10th round on the board. MIBR doing a great job here towards the end of this first half to actually make this comeback happen.
Okay. Man, if they were to close out this half, that'd be a hell of a turnaround. And I was starting to line up boards to start building a coffin because I didn't think MIBR were going to have too much going for
them. Had no rotation to come towards inner. We saw Henny go down very early towards upper. There's no opportunity for Luminosity to fight their way back into this round. Steel is actually going to make the attempt. They're going to go for it. They're not going to go for the save. Colzir taking down one as Bolts trading it out. Luminosity, with time winding down, are going for this retake.
I almost feel like it was just exit frags posturing towards this inner site. Lucas gets a kill there. They still don't have a chance of winning this round, but they've just expended a boatload of cash. The way I was looking at it was, okay, four survive with rifles, and then NECA's having $2,300 on this round, would be able to buy the AWP.
They still have plenty
next
of...
round. Ladies and gents, welcome back to the Pro League. Luminosity versus MIBR. If you're just now joining us, Luminosity won map one. We're heading into MIBR's pick of map two, but into this, laying down the law against MIBR. But MIBR closed out the half with five in a row to at least have the momentum coming into this.
Luminosity definitely with a little bit of a lackluster second half or second quarter of that first half. But starting off this pistol round, will be Nekiz taking down first. Phelps trades it out onto Lucas. The bomb should be going down momentarily as Phelps actually finds Bolts. Bolts finds Cold Zero too.
Yeah, we were trying to keep it a family show on that boost view right there. It's 2v3 right now. Luminosity having the advantage. The bomb is ticking out there as well, and you're losing more bodies. Taco, last man up. He is not a soft taco this time, more of a crunchy one considering he's got some chest armor in there. But he needs a miracle. He is surrounded. He doesn't know it, though. He's talking one to the face. And he's been flanked,
ooh,
but he deals with the flanker. So, you know, taking that shot to the head and surviving is nice because your armor is intact. He decided to keep his cash in hand. He still has enough for it if he wanted to, but by round's over, man. Gonna have to get it done with a shotgun, and you have an SMG in play, or sorry, a scout in play as well.
Thing is here, I don't even think that scout's gonna be in play for much longer as Fur falling back is gonna be running into Steel, who takes him down, and now that Mag 7 and Taco might be able to find something. However,
I mean, the clear out from Steel. He cleared out CT, and then I thought he was actually gonna come back and clear out the bottom side of Z connector. It might be. Hopefully they clear this out. Nobody's been there yet, but still he remains.
Doesn't look like he's going
to
be doing that. Taco will spot. Yeah, he can't take the fight. He can't take the fight
USP
at all. There you go. There you go.
One, two, three. Lucas dies to the bomb, actually. At a distance.
Nekiz has pushed his way out towards his bomb train right now, making that contact with Cold Zera as he gets tagged by Taco now. We're into a two-on-two. A two-on-one, though. Cold Zero going down behind that bomb train. Taco eating that nade, and Luminosity's got 12. Dallas outside now, and it does look like Luminosity will be hitting the A site.
Look at all this freedom of movement for Nekiz. He's like, well, everything's clear. I guess I'll just go past the bomb train. Fallen's here, point blank range for the MAC-10 underneath. Shoot again from under, and then over the top against Phelps. Fur is above in heaven, but can he leave? He needs Cold Zero, but he dies as well past the camera side of things. Nobody knows Fur's up here, though, yet. That could be a surprise. The bomb hasn't been planted.
I think Lucas has an idea.
Do they?
Yeah, Lucas was peering on up there earlier. He hasn't gone for the plant just yet. As Fur starts to peek his head out, he's going to be caught by this Ivy player now. And there it is. Steel spotted him, Steel taking him down. It's onto Taco with that AWP, but even in this moment, I do imagine Taco will be going for the save. Unfortunately, missing the shot is both of those players.
Taco gave up. I'm pretty sure Taco gave they float.
Yeah, being able to drop those AUGs are a massive part of this comeback for the MIBR side. They've got their work cut out for them. 7 rounds if they want to tie this one back up. So any type of gun save, any type of person alive to just keep those dollars in their pockets is massive. Luminosity, on the other hand, well, they're going to be buying up like nothing ever happened. 5 AKs on the field, not going towards those AWPs. And let's see what they start this round off with, and actually how MIBR are going to start this round. And it does look like they're playing a very heavy outside with two of their players pushing right up towards E-Box.
And Taco was actually initially aggressive in ramp, which is a bit scary because it's a bit risky because you have no other buddy to defend B if he were to die. So he goes halfway up the ramp, throws a grenade, and falls back. This could be a faster outer play. Fur is able to stop the front line of this, and no flashbangs come in to slow him down. He continually re-peaks this. Lucas is able to trade one back, but they're still behind by a fair margin. Now down by 2 players. They were stopped on the
nice
front
shot.
End, and now it's up to the rear end, the rear echelon. Steel, who is working on the lurk on the back side of Ivy, a late push in there to try and draw the attention back towards the site, ends up getting one, not able to convert or even step foot into the site either.
Yeah, that was great from MIBR pushing right up in their face, stopping that rush before it happened. Some great flashbangs from their team as well. Fallen pulling out that op, hitting some great shots. MIBR able to stop that middle hit before the T's even begin to get out. By the time we see Steel come into action towards Ivy, his teammates have already died. There's not much for him to do, and MIBR pick up a very nice round to get their 8th.
So MIBR are starting to march their way back into this game, but like we had said before, somebody else needs to stand up. Cold Zero is currently 23-19, the only player that's above 1 KDR, but Fallen has started to show up a little bit. We saw Fur getting into the mix of things as well, defending that towards the E-Box side. So MIBR is waking up. It might be a little bit late, but it is dramatic, and I love a dramatic game.
It always makes for the best entertainment, right?
Yeah.
Drama, whether in-game or maybe even sometimes out.
That's right. So just pistols here for Luminosity. Don't expect them to be able to win this round, but a bomb plant would mean rifles in the next.
Phelps actually didn't see this, so he's going to be able to find one, but both those players separated in the ladder, able to take Phelps down. Now Bolts has an AUG in his hands. Can he open up this outside area for his side?
Yeah, he's able to get to E-Box right now. The wall position from Lucas
Henny.
Is not successful. So the bomb has actually been dropped, so everybody is on deck for MIBR. It's 2v2, though, and look at the flank from Steel. He's always behind you. It's so frustrating. They know where Steel is right now, but it's a 1v1. These were just pistols for Luminosity. They looked innocent enough, and he got himself at least some damage. And there he gets the headshot.
Goodness.
Unreal. Fur does not manage to find the kills, and Luminosity eco it.
I love the way Steel played that 1v1, just jiggling, getting Fur to commit, getting Fur to control his recoil, essentially allowing Steel now to just come out, jiggle, 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 and here you see it. Fur's just committing to these shots, Steel's playing with it a little bit, and then ending up flying out and just taking Fur down to get Luminosity their 15th round on the board.
Unreal. MIBR have just been plagued by individual effort from Luminosity across the board, it seems. Henny and Steel are 24 and 23 kills each.
Oh.
And now they are into what could be the last round of the series. And yes, an upset. And even more so that it could happen in just 2 maps. Fallen's taking his off and pushing
aggro. Look at Fallen, he might get caught.
Yeah, but he's scoped in, so he can't quite flick back over. And now you have a double op set up for Luminosity in a 5-on-3 advantage. They have map control. They still look like they want to execute to the A site. Spraying through the floorboards and the ceiling. That should be it.
Yeah, this one should be going the way of Luminosity. Huge win for them here. A massive upset. Taco keeping this round alive, however, being able to take down Bolts, but he's still got a hill to climb if he wants to make this happen.
Yeah, he's got players behind him. He's heard it, though. He's going to climb onto the bomb train. He got himself the next one. Now he's got a chance. The 1v5 is developing, and he's got two 1v1s out in front of him, but Henny swings out with a Glock and ends it. 16-8. They do it in two maps.
Yeah, Luminosity upsetting everybody's predictions here today. Without you, I remember myself, my name. Forgot about all you tried to change.